beginning, the ending, it can be better. Come on, come on, give it to Jesus.
Amen.
I don't want to see you as a spectator.
That's right.
I want to see you as a player.
Amen.
Somebody say, I'm going to be a player.
I'm going to be a player.
Yeah, you need to be a player. We pay a lot to watch players. And they earn so much, we pay for them. Can you imagine that? We pay, and they entertain us, and they get a lot of money. That's why you must not be in the stand. You must be on the stage.
Amen.
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 Now, look at this. How can I succeed in 2019? If you look at the scriptures, Genesis chapter 12, I don't want to read so many of them. It's up to the end of that Genesis chapter 12. But look at the first four verses. The first four verses, it's that popular scripture that you know. If you don't even know it, you must have heard about it. You must have heard that Abraham left his father's house. I'm sure you've heard. Uh-huh. So sometimes there are scriptures you don't even need to read. People will tell you offhand what it is. But let me just read scriptures, because one thing I don't like is this. People go to church and they ask you, what scripture was read? He said, the preacher preached. What scripture? The preacher preached. What did he preach? Amen.
Amen.
Genesis 12. Now, let me read the first four and then we'll go from there. Now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, as you are going to get out of 2018.
Amen.
And from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show thee. And I will make of thee a great nation. And I will bless thee.
Amen.
And make thy name great.
Amen.
And thou shalt be a blessing.
Amen.
And I will bless them that bless thee.
Amen.
And curse them that curseth thee.
Amen.
And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed.
Amen.
Thank you for saying amen.
Amen.
So Abraham departed as the Lord had spoken unto him. And Lot went with him, and Abraham was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. People of God, please hear me. There is no point in living on this earth if you don't want to succeed. That's no point. There is no point to live every day a beggar. There is no point living every day of your life depending on others. Others can depend on you.
Yes.
You didn't understand that.
Yes.
God came to a family and brought out one man in that family and told the man, if you will go to where I will show you, he didn't say, tell him the place, where I will show you. Just like 2019, we're just going into it by faith.
Amen.
By faith. Just by faith. He said, but if you do it, I will bless you. I will make you great. I will give you a great name.
Amen.
Can I speak to somebody's life here?
Yes.
God is going to give you a new name in 2019.
Amen.
A new name.
Amen.
A new name. And he said, I'll be with you. Anybody who blesses you, I will bless.
Amen.
Whosoever will curse you, I will curse.
Amen.
And through you and by you,
amen,
all the families of the earth shall be blessed.
Amen.
Wow. Wow. Now, if you must be blessed and succeed in 2019, number one, which I'm not going to talk too much, you must obey God.
Amen. That's right.
Wow.
My God.
You must obey God. If he says go, what do?
Go.
Go. If he says sit down, sit down. If he says bring it, if he says bring all, bring all. Anyone that must succeed in 2019 must obey God. Obedience is the access to God's greatness. Obedience is the platform through which God will reach unto you. Those who obey God, they become a peculiar treasure to God. So you must obey God. It's important that you obey God. And when you obey him, you begin to see his wonders.
Amen.
I'm sure you know 2 Chronicles 20:20. Obey the word of God and you will be established.
Hallelujah.
Obey his prophet and you will prosper.
Amen.
Obedience. Do not sit with people who begin to go through logics. Can God really say that? Does God really want me to go hungry? Is God that bad? Do not debate the word of God. Whatever it tells you to do, do it. The mother of Jesus told those boys at the wedding, whatever he tells you to do, do it. And Jesus said, bring water, fill the pots with water. And he told them, draw out water and give to the governor. He didn't say draw out wine. It was their obedience that brought wine.
Come on.
Number two. Let me go. Number two, you must have an encounter with God. Many of us come to church, we don't have an encounter. That's deep. Many of us call the name of Jesus, but we are yet to have an encounter with Jesus. Now, in verse number 7 of the scripture I read, this man called Abraham, the moment he left home, and the Bible says, and the Lord appeared unto Abraham and said, unto thy seed will I give this land. And there builded he an altar unto the Lord who appeared unto him. Every encounter brings change.
Hallelujah.
Every encounter will never leave you the same. If you are the same from year to year, it is because you have not had that divine encounter. Nobody came to Jesus and remained the same. Nobody. The leper who left the colony and knelt before Jesus and said, Jesus, if you will, you can make me whole. And Jesus said, I will. And he made him whole. He never returned to the colony. He had a new location.
Yes, Lord.
An encounter gives you a new location.
Amen.
An encounter heals. An encounter promotes.
Amen.
Solomon had an encounter with God. And he was better than the kings before him and after him. After the encounter. Once you have an encounter with God, you will have the best. You need an encounter. Abraham had many encounters with God. The one that gave him Isaac, it began with an encounter. Genesis 18, verse number 1. He had an encounter with God. And what he never had came. The Manoahs had an encounter. And they had a son called Samson. Encounter brings great changes. Encounter will never leave you the same. Encounter with God will give you the purpose of your life. encounter with God will give you an assignment that God wants you to do. And you can't accomplish an assignment for God and God will never bless you. Jacob had an encounter with God, Genesis 32, verse 30. And he had to call the name of the place Peniel. He said, because I have seen God face to face. People who see God face to face don't remain the same. That man, before he got to Peniel, bet me, I will tell you, is a blessed man. But when he got to the place of the encounter, he said, bless me or I will not let you go. I thought you were blessed because I see the wagon you were coming with. I saw the children. I saw the maids. I saw the servants. I saw everything. I thought it was enough. But the man said, no. I realized that it is the blessing of God that maketh rich and added no sorrow. If he had no encounter with God, Esau would have destroyed everything. But after the encounter, he became a friend with Esau, who had promised that I would kill him when I see him. Encounter brings changes. You must do what? Encounter God. How do I encounter God? At the place of prayer. I'm going to that. When you begin to fast and yield to the Spirit, he will come in. Now, if you see what he did next, because he wanted to succeed, he raised an altar. That's in verse number 8. He raised an altar unto God. In verse number 8. Now, you need an altar. What altar? Altar of prayer. There are many altars. Altar of thanksgiving. On this altar, I don't do anything but just to praise God. On this altar, I don't do anything but just to thank God. Solomon had an altar of thanksgiving. But Abraham raised an altar. An altar of what? An altar of prayer. Because the Bible says, on that altar, he called upon the name of the Lord. Everyone that can pray is a destroyer of evil. Amen. Everyone that can pray has the key to open doors that no other person can open. The place of prayer is the place of exchange. The place of prayer is the place of power. You could see that Anna came to the place of prayer and she never remained barren. Anyone that can pray, you need an altar. Altar of prayer. And ask me, what is this altar? Do I need to put a table somewhere and put some things on? No. Wherever you said, God, I'll meet with you here every 6 a.m. in the morning, every day, or for the next 6 months, is your altar. It could be in your sitting room. It could be by your bedside. It could be anywhere. But you need to raise an altar. And once you say 4 a.m. every day, 12 noon every day, 1 a.m. every day, that is a place of your altar and is a place of covenant. You must keep that covenant because God keeps covenant. He prayed on that altar. He raised the altar. Everyone that prays will be saved. Joel 3, verse 32. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be delivered. And you need to be delivered. David raised an altar. Now look at this. First Chronicles 21:22. First Chronicles 21 and verse 22. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The scripture that David did, that I was talking about, David raised an altar. He went there and he said, give me this altar. And then, give me this place. I'm going to buy it and raise an altar so that there will be no more death. So that people die no more. He bought a place and raised it just to pray on behalf of the people. People of God, say, I know you are busy. I know you're busy, people. I know you want jobs. For the place of prayer, you can never wish it away. Prayer is important. Prayer is wonderful. Prayer tells me that you rely on God. Anyone who doesn't pray must have something else he's doing to sustain himself. Anyone who doesn't pray is a proud person. Prayer tells you that you submit to God.
Amen.
And that you want God to do it.
Amen.
Prayer. What do you think kept the people of old in the Bible? Prayer. Paul goes everywhere. Paul. In all us, you see, sometimes you don't know what is behind somebody's achievement. Paul, in the scriptures, everywhere he went, he would say, pray for us. Pray for us. Be praying for us that they may accept this word. Be praying for us that the doors may be opened unto us. Be praying for us. He knows the power of prayer. And you must know it. The power of prayer. You need to pray. Now let me just conclude by telling you two results of obedience, encounter, and the altar of prayer. What are the two results? Number one, kings will treat you well.
Amen.
That's right.
Let's go to Genesis 12, verse 16. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Kings will treat you well. Bible says, and he entreated Abraham very well for the wife's sake. And he had sheep and oxen, and he asses, maidservants, and she asses, and camels. When you have encountered God, when you have obeyed God, and when you have prayed, he makes kings to treat you well.
Hallelujah.
Hear me. 2019, great people will treat you well.
Amen.
Oh, tell me, is it possible?
Yes, sir.
No, it is possible.
Amen.
And I'll show you something. God raised 12 officers, 12, to attend and supply the needs of Solomon for 12 months of the year.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
12. Every officer will supply all that he needs for 1 month. And he lacked nothing.
Glory to God.
And that's how one officer after the other for 12.
Glory.
And I am keying you into that.
Yeah. Yeah.
12 men in 2019 will serve you. First Kings chapter 4.
Glory to God.
Verse number 7 and verse 27. 4:7. Now look at this first. Now, and Solomon had 12 officers over all Israel, which provided victuals for the king and his household. Each man his month in a year made provision. Allow me to read from NLT version, please. Solomon had 12 district governors who were all over all Israel.
They were responsible for providing food for the king's household. Each of them arranged provisions for 1 month of the year.
Amen.
Look at verse 27. Verse 27. The district governors faithfully provided for King Solomon and his court. Each made sure nothing was lacking during the month assigned to him. Oh, there will be divine assignment to serve you all through the year. Nothing shall be lacking. Nothing shall fail. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
12 men to provide every month, and they lacked nothing. They faithfully supplied all. Faithfully.
Yes, sir.
Do you know why you have to pray now? You have to pray for those 12 officers of yours that must supply all. Every man during his own month never failed. They faithfully provided and made sure nothing was lacking during the month assigned to them.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. And look at this, because this is my desire for you, 2019. Psalm 45 and verse number 12. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The princes of time will shower you with gifts.
Amen.
The wealthy will beg your favor. The wealthy will beg your favor. The wealthy will beg your favor. The princes will shower you with gifts. The wealthy will beg your favor. The wealthy will beg your favor. In the name of Jesus. Can I buy you a house? Can I buy you a car? The wealthy will beg your favor.
Amen.
Is somebody still here with me? The wealthy will beg your favor.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Don't be surprised. Somebody will walk up to you and say,
"Hey,
hey.
Would you like me to buy you a Benz?
Right here.
Yes, sir. Somebody said
the wealthy
will beg me.
Will beg me.
Favor.
Favor.
Hallelujah.
Hey, that's the number.
Do me a favor, please. Oh, yeah, I like to do anything. Do you mind if I buy you a house?
Come on.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
let me close with this. I told us, if you obey God, because the Bible says that when your obedience is complete, then God will fight all those that trouble you.
Yes.
When your obedience is complete.
Yes, sir.
Guys, listen to me. You can do guy with anybody, but in the household of God, drop that guy.
Come on.
Obey God.
Amen.
Jesus.
Whatever you need, it's just by you only if you can obey.
Amen.
Find a way to testify this year that I had an encounter with God.
Amen.
raise an altar of prayer.
Yes.
Then great people will begin to treat you well.
Amen.
Princes will bring you, shower you with gifts.
Amen.
God will raise men, 12, that will take care of you every
Amen.
Month.
Amen.
Every month. Every month, 12 officers, 12 months of the year, and none of them failed. Finally, God will fight them that will want to take away your joy. In verse 17 of Genesis 12, they took away the joy of Abraham. They took Sarah. And then they found out later that she shouldn't be taken away. But before they returned Sarah, God had plagued the whole house of Pharaoh.
Wow.
God had plagued them. God will fight for those who will be with him.
Amen.
Those who will say, Lord, I don't have any power of my own. Please help me.
Yes.
I have no power of my own. Those are the ones God is looking for.
Amen.
Those who will always be in his altar, in his church. Those who will be somewhere serving him. God fights for them. Those who will obey him, God fights for them.
Amen.
Those who fear him,
Amen.
Those who submit unto him,
Amen.
Those who will not hide anything from him,
Amen.
Those who believe that whatever I have belongs to him,
Amen.
God fights for them.
Amen.
Those who want to take away your joy in 2019
yes.
are in for trouble.
Amen.
Genesis 20, verse 1 to 18. Abimelech took the wife of the same Abraham, and God plagued all the women, all. Not just, it made Abimelech sick, plagued the wife, and all the women, maids, servants, everyone in the house of Abimelech were in trouble because of one man.
Ah, Jesus!
He said, return this woman and he will pray for you.
Amen.
It was until Abraham prayed for him that everyone in that house was well.
Amen.
I pray for you.
Amen.
God will make you stronger than your enemies.
Amen. Hallelujah.
God, I shall have you see. Now look at what it says in Psalm 105, verses 14 and 15. 105. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. 14. I'm reading the NLT version. It says, yet did not let anyone oppress them. He warned kings on their behalf. He did not let any man oppress them. Can I bend my knees to pray for you? 2019, no man shall oppress you. 2019, no man shall oppress you. In the name of Jesus. On your behalf, God will warn kings. And in verse 15, he said, touch not my
chosen people.
Touch not my
chosen people.
Do not hurt my
prophets. Yes.
God. Yet he did not let anyone oppress them.
Yes.
He didn't let anyone. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
If you do the word of God, then you are in for success.
Amen.
Because if nobody is oppressing you, then who's going to say, no. The doors that are open for you 2019, no man shall close it.
Amen.
Your past shall be shining and shining and shining and shining and shining brighter. In the name of Jesus. You are in for great things. May the Lord, my God, empower you to overcome giants. In the mighty name of Jesus. Where you have been under before, you will be over. Where you have been under before, you will be above. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because I have seen you December 2018, you will be alive December
2019.
Amen. Hey! Glory! Hey! Jesus! Do you know dogs? Dogs.
Yeah,
dogs. Dogs. Some of them do swallow stones. The stone never hurts them.
Wow.
It passes out as water.
Hey. Wow.
Can I pray for you?
Yes.
Every attack from today,
yes,
in the dream, in the physical,
amen,
it shall not hurt you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen,
the Lord my God will help you.
Amen.
He will fight your battles.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He will not forsake you.
Amen.
He will not leave you alone.
Amen.
2019, you will succeed.
Amen.
May the Lord give you the grace and power to obey Him.
Amen.
You will have an encounter with God.
Amen.
You will have an encounter with God.
Amen.
The Lord will give you the great changes you need in life.
Amen.
You will never remain the same again.
Amen.
Encounter of healing you will have.
Amen.
Encounter of deliverance you will have.
Amen.
Encounter of joy you will have.
Amen.
Encounter of promotion you will have.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
2019,
amen,
kings will serve you.
Amen.
Great people will bless you.
Amen.
Wealthy people will ask you for favor.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree by this time, 2019, if we meet, I will pray for you.
Amen.
I will not pray for your dead body.
Amen.
I will not pray for you on the hospital bed.
Amen.
I will pray for you because you are alive.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God lift you higher and higher.
Amen.
And give you a voice. God will give you a voice.
Yeah. Come on.
Oh, Jesus.
God will make you a voice.
Amen.
You will speak in places,
yes, sir,
where you have spoken before and they won't listen, but now they will listen to you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord my God will bless you.
Hallelujah.
He will make you great.
Hallelujah.
Greater than any man can imagine.
Amen.
Greater than any man can paint.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I have heard a testimony of speed today.
Amen.
But it is not a speed for one person.
Come on.
It is speed for all of you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever you have lost is coming back 100 times. I stand on this exalted altar.
Yes, sir.
I join my faith with the faith of the bishop of this house. I decree in the name that is above every other name, 2019, you are more than a conqueror. It shall be your time of harvest. The Holy Ghost will be rooted in you to do exploits. There shall be fresh start every day.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is your year that your destiny, destiny for greatness will begin to manifest.
Amen.
From January to December, you will be grateful to God.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for you.
Amen.
Because I can see you. There is a connection. between you and the powers that be.
Yeah.
There's a connection.
Yes, sir.
Between you and the people that will say, anything you need, take it.
Yes.
Take it.
Have it.
In the name of Osikaya and Libra, 2019, there will be somebody like God who told Abraham, look up, as far as your eyes can go, I will give you. As far as you can see in 2019, you will have it. The power of the Almighty God is upon you.
Amen.
You key into these blessings.
Yes.
I will hear the testimony in your life.
Amen.
As the power of God is upon you.
Amen.
The anointing of God is soaking you.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hear me. The Bible says, they shall hear my voice and they will run away from their hiding places. Every sickness in your body they call terminator. May the voice that I speak today terminate it in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
You will not die.
Amen.
You will live.
Amen.
You will declare the works of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Your status is changing.
Amen.
Your status is changing.
Amen.
Your status is changing.
Amen.
Your shape is changing.
Amen.
The glory is coming upon you afresh.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hear me. I don't know how long you have been in this land. And it's as if you're not making it. But whenever a man wakes up, it's his own money. Somebody is here. I don't know whether you're a man or a woman, but your money begins in 2019. 2019, because your money is about to begin, I greet you good morning. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Powers will bow before you. Great ones will bow before you. In the name of Jesus, the Lord my God bless you. Please give me a handshake. Thank you. Yes, because there's going to be a great handshake. Is going to add color to your life.
Amen.
Whatever will not allow that color is going off now.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Everybody, please lift up your two hands. Lift up your two hands. To your hands now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I thank you.
Thank you.
I have spoken to men and women that must live and succeed.
Amen.
In 2019.
Amen.
I will return and I will hear your testimony.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
shall give Jesus.